Hi, this is Mehdi with Full Stack Library, and today we'll answer the big question, why use Flexbox? Why at first we should use Flexbox? Here I have a problem that I need to solve by writing hacky CSS. And for that, I create a class clearfix, and I need to use it once I have this problem. And for that, I will go here and I write clearfix. So I need to clearfix element every time I will have the same problem. I'm just using an image and floating it to the right. And once I have the problem, I need to use this hacky CSS. And this is not a good thing. So the other problem, if I want to manage layouts by using floats. And as you see here, I have header, section, aside, and footer. And if I add another section, let's just add another one. You'll see that we'll have a problem right here. This aside right here, it will not take 100% of the height. And the other problem, if I remove this clear both right here, so it will just be at the top and I need to clear the element once I will have a problem. And this is also considered as writing hacky CSS in order to manage elements by using floats. So to summarize, float isn't considered 100% a way to manage layout, because once you rely on floats, you'll end up with a messy CSS. To solve this problem, we have a Flexbox module, and the developer of CSS tried to give us a module so that can help us to manage layout with a more accurate way. And what's Flexbox is exactly, as you see here, I'm just giving a look at the specs, and the specs aren't 100% for everyone. They are just for people who want to go deeply and understand deeply what Flexbox do exactly. If you are interested, if you are this kind of person, you can go through the details on how to use Flexbox. I'll explain that in this course. To summarize, Flexbox module is considered as an effective way to lay out and align and distribute space along a single column or row. So think of that like using floats on steroids. So we can align elements even if you don't know the size. And you can get into a simple example right here using Flexbox. So I can align elements even if I don't know exactly what the viewport or the size of the viewport and the size of the element. So it will be just align it like that. I'm just resizing that. And this is a created layout using Flexbox. Other interesting things about Flexbox is if we take a look here as can I use. This is a website just tell you if you can use a specific property, CSS property. Let's just take Flexbox. And you see here, it is fully supported. You see that we have Firefox, Chrome, Safari, and Opera, and even iOS Safari. So all of the newest version, even the oldest one. So it's fully supported and you can use that right now in your website without any worry of this cross-browser's validations.